afternoon. I'm here to discussing about our assignment, Group 19 for Engineering Quality Control, EBT-109. So these are my members, and I'm the first one, Lee Jiawei, and we have total 4 members. And our title is, you would like to build a badminton court. Using suitable management and planning tools, plan a series of activities to be carried out. Estimate the duration of the project. So we are choosing the activity and network diagram because we are able to estimate the duration of project, and we are also able to conduct the activity in the same time. For example, this one is an example of activity network diagram. And this one is an activity network diagram of our assignment. So I will tell more about step one. So step one is to identify work site, prepare plan, and obtain approval, which takes 12 days. So we are going to identify work areas for construction and also provide safety guidelines. And we are going to prepare planning in activities that needed to be noted in the documents. And thirdly, we are also need to get specific permit license or approval from the government in order for our construction to be carried on. So for example, this one is a building permit of Malaysia. Secondly, this one is a step two, which takes about 12 days, and it will end at day 22. So this one is a construction loans, which take 10 days. And we are going to find a suitable bank company to apply loan. As you can see, there's a lot Malaysia bank in here, and they provide different interests. So we have to survey one by one which provide us the lowest interest. And also we have to prepare official documents for the badminton court, for example, the building permits and the utilized fees, and contractor needed by the banker. And thirdly, it normally takes around 6 days and up to maximum 10 days for the bank to review the document in order to get our loan to be approved. So step three, which takes 5 days, and it will start at the day 12 and as the earliest day is 17, but it also can end at the day 19. So step three is to purchase space for badminton court, which takes 5 days, as I mentioned just now. And we are going to search for area which is suitable to build a badminton court in terms of the softness of soil, the size of area we are going to construct, and other external or internal factors. And also we have to make evaluation based on the test and analyze the result that we carry out, for example, according to the soil property, ventilation, and others. And also we have to compare the market price from one to another in order to control our budget. And the last thing, we have to prepare document and contract with the land owner in order to faster the relationship for us to get the land. So the step four is takes 3 days, and it can start the earliest is the day 17, and it can end at the earliest at day 20, and also it can end the latest at day 22, because this one is ended at 22, so we have to be the same day to in order to carry out the step 5. So this arrow are considered as critical path. So the step 4 is to find construction manager, engineers, and workers, which takes only 3 days. So from here, we have to complete a market survey on which construction company has the lowest rate, but also the best quality construction products with paper license and worker with permits. And also we have to negotiate the price for quotation based on our budget. And next, we'll only start the construction once the quotation is agreed for both sides. And also we have to make sure the construction company is doing the project diagram and constantly update the progress in the construction site. For example, this one is an example of the project diary. As you can see, they will write a progress update for every week, and this one they will write for what they are going to do for next month, so that they are to make sure that construction are keep on the track. And next, the step 5 is takes about 4 days. It will start at day 22 and end at day 26. So step 5 is to brainstorm and design project, which takes 4 days. So we will conduct a meeting and brainstorm between the construction manager and the architecture, and to come up with an official plan of the badminton court. And they have to suggest and the type of material which will be used for the whole construction journey. So quantity surveyor have to estimate the total amount of material need to be used so that no extra material will be wasted. And also they have to foresee the problem which they are going to face for in the future, and come up with a solution so that when there is a problem in the next time, they will solve very fast. And now step 6, which takes around 5 days, and it start at the day 26 and end as a day 31. So the step 6 is to provide equipment and materials, which takes 5 days as I mentioned. So here we have to search for the materials, supplier for the material company, and we have to also negotiate the price, but in the same time we have to ensure the quality of material. And also we have to ensure the delivery time and date for the material to reach our construction site so that we will have no delay in our construction. So below you can see is an example of our construction.
Hi, Assalamualaikum and Salam Sejahtera. My name is Muhammad Izzubi Hafiz. So I will continue the point for the step 7 is prepare site. This step need 3 days. The crew clear the site, put a wooden form to serve as a template, footings are installed. Using a backhoe and a bulldozer, the crew clears the site of rocks, debris, and trees for the house and if at pit level, the specific system. Put up wooden form to serve as a template for the foundation and digs the hole and trench. Footing, which is structures where the house interface with the earth and support it, are installed. So this example for poor foundation and bulldozer clear the site. Next step at 8, poor foundation which need 2 days to complete. The hole is dug, the footings are formed and poured, and the foundation wall are formed and poured. During concrete is poured, there are no activity on the construction site. The crew applies a waterproofing membrane to the foundation walls, install drains, sewer and water taps and any plumbing. If the home has a full basement, the hole is dug, the footing are formed and poured, and the foundation walls are formed and poured. Once concrete is poured into the hole and trench, it will need time to cure. During this period, there will be no activity on the construction site because this activity needs time to make sure the concrete is hard and is complete hard. After the concrete is cured, the crew applies a waterproofing membrane to the foundation wall, install drain, sewer and water taps and any plumbing that need to go into the first floor slab or basement floor and backfills excavated dirt into the hole around the foundation wall. So the step 9 is complete rough framing, rough plumbing and electrical, which is need 4 days to complete. So lay wood or oriented standard board with OSB sheeting is applied. The sheeting is then covered with a protective barrier. Start running pipes and wires through the interior walls, ceiling and floors. Sewer lines and vents as well as water supply lines for each fixtures are installed. Pipe and one shower units are put in. Lights and switch are run wires from the breaker panel to each receptacle. Next is step 10. Step 10, which is installing air conditioner, airways and insulation, which is need 3 days to complete. Ductwork is installed for the air conditioning system. Airways installed through the roof and installed in the floor, wall and ceiling. Note, plumbing are usually installed before wiring because it is easier to run wires around pipes and ducts than vice versa. The most common type of insulation used is new hull of fiberglass, cellulose and foam. Depending on the region and climates, your builder may use mineral wool. So this is usually air conditioner that contractor use. After that, so that's all from me. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum and salam sejahtera. My name is Nur Adila binti Shamsul Mu'ad. I will continue the next point, which is complete drywall and interior textures. This step will be done within 4 days. First is mark drywall based on the measurement. After the marking activity is done, then we take and hang the drywall. Then we apply the primer coat of paint to the drywall. The function is to increase the paint durability and provides additional protection for the surface of the material. There is a support for the primer coat, which is wash primer, shot primer, filler primer, and sealing primer. Then we proceed with the exterior finishes, which is brick, stucco, stone, and siding. The example of brick is common burnt clay bricks, sandblind brick, engineering bricks, and concrete bricks. While the example of stucco is dash, pebble dash, smooth, sand, and glaze. The example of stone is marble, granite, travertine, and limestone. And the lastly, siding. The example of siding is fiber cement, wood siding, and metal siding. Here is some example of stucco and stones. So we go to the next point, which is finish interior trim. This activity will be carried out within 3 days. First, install exterior driveways and walkways. The reason why the driveway is installed is to avoid the concrete from damage because of the heavy equipment such as truck. It provides a proper way for the truck to in and out from the construction site. While the function of walkways is to ease the visitors for them to visit the construction site and to avoid the shoes of visitors from getting muddy. Next is install the interior doors, baseboards, door casings, window sills, moldings, lusters, and other decorative things. There are 2 types of molding that can be installed on the floor against the baseboard, which is quarter round and shoe molding. We choose shoe molding because it is more attractive and more thicker than quarter round. And then paint or wallpaper the wall that is necessary. So the next step is install hard surface flooring and countertops. This activity will be done within 3 days. The example of hard flooring is ceramic tile, vinyl, and wood flooring. And for the court of badminton court is we use PVC rubberized spots or artificial turf. Or we can simply use the wooden floor for the court as well. Then we grading the exterior finish. This reason to ensure a proper drainage and it is required a structure inspection. Next is install other equipment such as netting system, scoreboard, referee seats, player and coach seats. And the final step is paint the lines on the court based on the specification measurement. That's all from me. Thank you.
Good day everyone, I'm Sineshwari. Next step is step 14. It took 3 days to finish it. We plan to start in 42nd day and finish it by 45th day. But unfortunately, we need to start in 43rd day and finish it by 46th. The step four is, the step was is, step is finish mechanical trims. Okay. Light fixtures, outlets and switches were installed and the electrical panel was completed on time. Heating, ventilation and air conditioning equipment was installed and registered completely. The next step is step 15. It took 3 days to finish it. We plan to start in 45th day to and finish it by 47th day. And we accurately finish it in the same day as planned. The step was installed bathroom fixtures. Sinks, toilets and faucets were arranged in place. All sets were in good order as Next step is step 16. It took 3 days to finish it. We plan to start in 47th day and finish it by 49th day. As planned, we finish it in the same day. The step was install mirrors and shower doors. Mirror, shower doors and carpeting was fixed and final cleanups took place one time. The shower doors for girls' shower room are fully secured. Next step is step 17. It took 3 days to finish it. The step was started in 45th day and 48th day. But unfortunately, delay to start. We start in 46th day and finish it by 49th day. Step 17 is finish flooring and finish exterior landscaping. Trees, shrubs and grass plant at outside and other exterior landscaping works were finished and completely. A building code officially completes a final inspection and certificate of occupancy was issued. If any defects were found during this inspection, a follow-up inspection may be scheduled to ensure they have been to be corrected. The final step is step 18. It took 3 days to finish it. We planned to start in 49th and finish by 52. As planned, we finish it. Final walkthrough. The builders will walk you through your new permitted code to acquaint you with these features and the operation various system and components and explains on your responsibility for maintenance and upkeep, as well as warranty coverage and procedures. It also an opportunity to spot items that need to be corrected or adjusted, so be attentive and observed. Sometimes this will arise because the homeowner discovers a crotch in the countertop after move on, and there's no way to prove whether it was caused by the builder's crew or the other movers. This is a few words about inspection. Your new permitted code will be inspected periodically during the course of construction. To maintain inspection for code compliance, your builder may be conduct quality check at critical points in the process. This is our permitted code project. Thank you for watching.